Well, yeah, now we're having different outcomes of our episodes.
Rachel's not in the play. Mm-hmm. We did nothing about that.
Yeah.
Mikey got hurt. Drew didn't get his knees buckled in.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And he keeps a scholarship.
Yep. Oh, and Skip doesn't quit. He keeps his job and everything, so.
Yeah. Playing opposites.
Yeah, definitely. Quick thing, whenever I played this, I was having a really hard time, especially on this part where, number one, I could not hear any audio. Number two, no one's mouths were moving. it was so weird.
That happened to me in part one, or the other game too.
Yeah.
Oops.
Chloe and Steph, I'm on my way to the hospital. Mikey's arm is broken. She told me a little bit about what happened. Shit, I didn't know it was that bad. Situation so fucked up. No shit.
Louder.
Let me know if there's any way I can help. Thanks, I will.
Or having to watch Victoria butcher Rachel's role.
But yeah, like, can be here for Rachel. Talk to everybody and like, just cause like no one's mouths were moving and like I couldn't hear any audio. And like, it froze on me like twice. And like I had to restart it. And it was annoying.
Drama teachers always seem so dramatic.
Dramatic.
Sup, Mr. Keaton.
Why, if it isn't the muse of the Blackwell Drama Department.
Tell me, young lady, do you still believe true love exists?
Yeah, and she's not in the play.
Yes.
Sure, I think so. But it's a lot weirder and scarier than poets and pop songs make it out to be.
You might be surprised, my dear. Budding dramaturge, may your propitious appearance
counter the
tragedy of Stephanie Gingrich's sudden recusal. An emergency, she says.
Oh, yes.
Word.
Our lion of the light board.
Okay, so that's the word.
Platitudinal though it may be, the show must sojourn forth.
That dude is weird.
Yeah?
He just leaves.
Bye.
After all the work Steph did, it's amazing that she would drop everything to be there for Mikey.
Dana! Damn it.
How's your super long errand going? Yo, crazy shit happened in Drew's room, like really bad. Oh no, are you okay? Do you need to talk about it? Yeah, later. Too many people around now. I'm backstage. Great. On my way.
On my way. Dana!
On my way to fuck Dana. Your beach.
Did Doug dig David's garden? Or did David dig Doug's? Did Doug dig David's garden? Or did David
talk to me?
Betty bought a bit.
Okay.
Of butter, but she found the butter bitter. Betty bought a bit.
Sucks
of
for Betty.
Bought a bit of butter.
Okay.
Go.
Poison the drinks.
No, not there.
There's this guy, there's these people, yeah. There's drug posters, stuff that I don't care about.
Talk to her.
Samantha?
Yeah.
Who are you?
That's some shameless eavesdropping there, Samantha.
She's the one that's like in love with
Elliot?
No, with Nathan.
Oh.
Nathan.
Yeah.
Please.
I can't do it, Dad.
Listen.
You don't understand. They all hate me. They're just gonna laugh at me. And the football team will just bully me more.
Why do you suppose that is?
I don't know.
Because you show weakness. Just like you're doing right now.
Because you're not murdering them, son.
When you learn that this isn't about you and your problems. This is about the Prescott name. my name.
Damn.
You will not embarrass me.
Jesus.
Yes.
He's good. Like shaking.
Now.
Yeah, this is the first time I've ever seen Nathan's father too.
I'll see you after the show.
So, yeah.
Say something.
Great pep talk, Mr. P. Everyone knows the best way to instill confidence in someone is by intimidating them.
I don't know who you are, but mind your own business.
I'd love to. Don't you have, like, a private bunker filled with gold coins where you could have these conversations?
And that's when he had the idea to build a bunker to have people killed him.
I wouldn't be surprised, honestly.
Oh, come on!
Fuck!
You should be happy I told your dad off when you couldn't. It's not like he's gonna get mad at you.
Alright, talk to stuff real quick. Talk to stuff.
Hey. Nathan's dad is... some asshole.
The biggest of anuses.
I wish he'd just go away and leave him alone.
You should be careful. He should be thankful. You should be careful.
Nathan's dad sucks. But you should be careful what you wish for when it comes to parents.
Oh, Chloe. I wasn't thinking. I'm sorry.
For what?
No, you're not.
You didn't kill my dad. Or did you?
Max Caulfield did.
That was a joke.
On purpose.
Your dark sense of humor reminds me a lot of Nathan's. Actually, the two of you are really similar.
Oh, this is that girl that doesn't know how to talk to me.
What the hell does that mean?
I'm serious.
Yeah.
You're both artistic and surprisingly sensitive. You've been through a lot, and a lot of people...
There's a lot of characters that are in this one that they really...
He needs help.
They go into, like... their character developments, but it's not as much as you would hope. Like, especially with her. Like, I would have loved to know more a little about her and, like, how she fits into everything.
Yeah.
And whatnot.
Give him space, give him help, give him up.
Give him help. Because, I mean, you also gotta think, I mean, like, this is, like, Nathan, and, like, his father is, like, this is a major asshole to him.
But she likes him.
Oh yeah, that's what she's asking, like, what should I do?
I know.
So give him help.
No. I don't think he needs help right now. I think he needs space.
I don't know.
He needs space.
When I'm super angry, I need to let it all out. The last thing I want is someone trying to calm me down.
You were wrong about it last time, so
involved with him and Drew yesterday.
What was I wrong about?
The other thing was Rachel.
Oh, yeah. That one was actually,
all your fault, I remember.
No, whatever happened, she would have had the same outcome no matter what.
Hmm.
Not if, whenever I did it. So.
You're still wrong. And now I'm upset I helped. Divide her.
Wouldn't want to leave the great wall of bitchiness back in the drama lab, I guess.
I say,
RA will suck as a press beta. If VC had any talent, maybe. Can you look at it, or will it say the same thing?
It just says look.
Oh.
If VC had any talent, Victoria Chase had any talent, maybe she wouldn't have gotten the part.
She would have gotten the part.
Talent, is that what? Got Mr. K to cast you, slut? Jesus. I don't know. We've seen what Victoria does to try and get other stuff. Wait, so can I actually go and talk to Nathan?
I don't know.
Hey, Hayden.
I think you can.
Address me as Ferdinand, good lady.
Okay, Ferdy.
go fuck yourself.
Right. Hey, go fuck yourself.
Super lame, Chloe. I mean, super lame, fair maiden.
Super lame.
That was like totally super lame.
Method acting.
Really? Thanks.
Wow. Dude is clueless. Let me see if I can talk to him.
Boys changing tent.
Okay.
Oh.
Thanks, but no thanks.
Good call.
Mm-hmm. Now, all I think for you to do is just go to the woman's.
Can arms. I go back here?
No.
No, I can't. What about these lights? Oh, I could play?
If I know Steph, she must have been super excited to be the lion of the light board tonight. Sucks.
Play!
Chloe Price presents Firewalk Laser Light Spectacular.
I wonder if there's the Anarchy one. Oh.
Maybe it'll show up during the play. At the worst time.
That'd be hilarious.
See anything?
No way in hell.
Okay.
You gotta. Yeah, you gotta. Put the.
Okay, no. Let's see you naked again.
Huh.
She's gonna be making out with someone.
You got this. You got this.
Do you need some help?
Shit, shit,
I can give you
shit.
Some help.
I can't do this. I'm going to ruin the play.
Yes, you are.
What are you two doing here?
Two? Oh, hello.
Or did you forget? You let this loser dropout sabotage you. Just like she tried to sabotage me yesterday.
I'll do it again right now.
I should be thanking you. Now I have everything I wanted. And you've got a new friend. So I guess we're both doing great.
Fantastic.
Now, please, so I can get ready for my performance.
Even though I wish I was the one performing tonight, Victoria, I really am happy for you. I hope it's everything you want it to be. We both do. Right, Chloe?
Sure. Ooh.
Get Victoria to quit. Now, who would be the person who replaces her? I don't think they would have any options.
Duh.
But to put Rachel.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm getting you to quit.
Rachel might be taking the high road, but not. I know how much she wants to perform.
All I so, need to do just is whenever I had done this,
best interest to quit. I don't know.
Victoria actually had like medicine that she was gonna give to Rachel to like get her stump to like make her like all high and everything.
Suicide.
And that's how she Victoria would have done it. Would have been become the lead and everything. And so
take advice from a loser like me, Greek. Horace, lost your mind?
What? I don't.
Don't you know your Shakespeare? Ooh. 'Tis better to have loved and lost than never to have gone on stage and made a complete ass of yourself in front of everybody. Ever.
People love theater. It's cool.
Quit now. Theater of War. Theater in the round. Theater of War?
High school is war. Theater is that part of war where you get impaled by a spear and you shit your guts out and then all your friends abandon you.
Jesus.
Damn.
The dramatic arts at Blackwell are venerated by... what am I saying? I don't have to justify myself to you.
Come
my
on.
God. My
Drama God. Queen, dramatic... Dramatic irony...
Hey, you won. Look at you.
But trust me. If you go on stage tonight... You'll be the only one out there not getting the joke.
Chloe, you're being a little harsh, don't you think?
Shut your hole.
No, she's right.
She is?
I quit.
I am?
I am?
I can't go out like this. I can't play this part. I don't know the lines. I don't understand the stupid play. I don't even like theater.
You don't know the lines?
Hello? I was cast as understudy to you? What were the chances I was actually going to be?
You cast? Never know.
So.
You never know.
I quit. The show can go to hell for all I care. I'm not going down with it.
Hey, take the costume off. We need that.
You outdid yourself, Price.
I guess I did.
I better get ready. Oh, hey. That's mine. the gloomiest shirt of the bunch. How did I know you were gonna pick that one?
Because she's not preppy.
Prospera knows all.
Oh, okay. I better start getting into costume before.
Sweet tarnations, we're ruined.
Sweet tarnations.
That was quick.
My dear young artists, a misfortune most unkind has befallen us. Oh yeah. Juliet.
This is funny.
That infernal inferno is the culprit, closing down the roads and robbing us of our Ariel. Would that she could but manifest on her master's whim as a true spirit. Alas, devoid of an understudy, the situation is a dire one indeed.
So dramatic.
I'm afraid we may have to cancel.
So they lost two people.
Yeah.
Truly, we are a cursed lot.
Put Chloe in.
Prodigious imagination cannot conceive.
That's what's gonna happen.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh God.
I will not abide this lack of professionalism any longer. I quit.
Victoria.
Bye.
I am protesting the entire Blackwell Arts program. It's time our talents were appreciated and not squandered by subpar faculty. Good luck with your train wreck.
Damn.
Your mom.
Touché, fates. Touché.
Touché, indeed.
Mr. Keaton, perhaps I could fill in for Victoria?
My dear, your visage is as a vessel sent by the heavens to offer passage to my stranded soul. But I'm afraid without our Ariel, all is still lost.
No.
What?
No.
Oh, no. Mr. Keaton.
No.
Chloe could step in for Juliet.
No fucking chance.
At least until the road's clear.
No.
The romantic.
She's the right fit for Juliet's costume.
She is indeed. Tell me, my dear, have you ever acted before?
Nope.
No.
Hell no.
I have one emotion and it's anger.
All the time. And she's fantastic at it.
We play improv games.
What if I told you that the entire fate of the production rests upon your slender shoulders?
I'd say you're super fucked.
Please. For me.
Well, if it's for you, I have no choice.
I'll give you a kiss later.
It's for my bae. Wow.
I can't believe Rachel's talked me into this.
Frank.
My
birdie. Frank.
What do you want?
I just talked to Damon. Good work. You can meet me tomorrow to pick up your cut. Your friend's an asshole. What matters is he's happy. Whatever. Price. You did the right thing.
I sure did. I didn't get people's knees broken. Like some other mustache.
Alright, cool. I guess I'm the dick now.
Kinda. Yeah, you got his knees broken.
You know what? At least I didn't kill Kate.
At least I didn't lose a kid's scholarship.
I didn't kill Kate.
I didn't ruin that kid's life.
I didn't kill Alyssa
either. I didn't
either.
Destroy the entire city of Arcadia Bay, which includes Kate, which you did kill. Oh,
you
right.
Suck.
That's right.
I hate you. Shut up.
Kill the whole city.
So for this, I actually took pictures of the lines because I didn't want to fuck it up. So,
oh, yeah. I'm not going to even try to.
Here, let me take pictures. Let me take pictures.
No. I'm not going to cheat.
By accident, most strange, bountiful.
Are these only my lines?
No, Ariel is yours, so all hail, great master, I come to answer thy best pleasure.
Okay, that's all I need to know is Ariel stuff.
All hail, great master, that's it. Prospero Ariel, I boarded the kingship in every cavern, I flamed amusement, the fire and cracks of sulfurous roaring and the mighty Neptune seemed to besiege and make his blood waves tremble.
Bold waves.
Bold waves, whatever.
Blood waves.
Not a soul. The king's son, Ferdinand, was the first man that cried, hell is empty and all the devils are here. I feel like that's a song. Not a hair perished, and as thou badst to me, I have dispersed them about the isle in troops. Is there more toil? Let me remember thee. What thou hast promised. My liberty! That's Prospero. My noble master. Ariel exits. And
sure.
Elliot.
Elliot.
Chloe, the show is starting. We get great seats. Where are you? Oh, you'll see. Don't worry, Warren, number two.
This will be interesting.
Why does it feel like Steph is mocking me from afar?
See me or Mr. K for makeup kits. Talking graffiti.
I didn't know that.
Life gives you lipstick, use it to tag shit.
Oh, yeah.
Death tragedy.
Got it.
Because this whole thing will be a tragedy.
I wonder what death was. What if it was the other one?
The smiling one? I guess so.
Oh, I don't know. I don't know what the smiling one.
I'm pretty sure that's what the two masks represent. Death and tragedy.
But isn't there like a third one too?
Maybe. I don't know. I don't know. I don't do any of this stuff. Hey, there's my costume.
Prospera.
Miranda. I think we're done here, right?
Yeah. Pretty much. Nothing else to do.
Maybe.
Yeah, you're done.
Script. I've memorized nothing. I'm good.
Yeah, that's true. We didn't
big debut.
Memorize it.
Joy.
I changed the costume. Oh, God. So, did you get it all right, or did you mess it up?
No, I got it all right, but... What's weird is that
most strange, bountiful fortune.
She goes a little off script, and you'll see.
Here, cease more questions. Thou art inclined to sleep. 'Tis a good dullness, and give it way.
Yeah, so back to what we said in the first episode. If anyone knows the whole theme of this play and all that, please let us know, because we have no idea what this play is and all that.
That's you.
I am ready now.
That's me.
Up there,
you little shit.
Go up there, peacock.
My Ariel, come.
Damn it.
Crow. Damn it.
Damn it. So go to the X.
Walk to Rachel and say my line.
I like how I can look at stuff and talk about it. Let me try that. Don't mind me.
Killed my eyes.
Oh my god.
Tough crowd.
Oh, I could look at the ship. Let me look at the ship.
People are just thinking like
at least supposed to do something with this.
Oh, look.
Look, there's the A. Found it. Found the anarchy.
Alright, talk to Rachel.
I haven't seen the rock.
Rachel, for getting me into this.
Oh my god. Anyways.
All hail, great mistress. I come to answer thy best pleasure. Most fearless.
How she talks.
Hast thou performed to point the tempest that I bade thee?
I boarded the king's ship.
I don't remember.
You just read it all.
Yeah, that doesn't mean I remember it.
I boarded the king's ship. In every cabin,
what?
I blamed amazement.
I don't think that was right.
I don't know.
No, yeah, that's right.
I guess.
That part's right.
The most mighty Neptune seemed to besiege.
It's the wrong thing.
Old waves tremble.
My brave spirit, who was so firm. So constant that this coil would not infect his reason. Not a soul. The king's son, Ferdinand, was the first man that leaped from his ship and cried.
Oh, havoc. Hell is empty.
Hell is empty?
Yeah.
Cried, hell is empty and all the devils are here.
Yes.
I would not get on that stage in a million years.
Oh no.
Safe? All right. I guess.
Now she's standing.
When I'm supposed to walk somewhere.
Walk to the ship.
The ship.
Yeah, you gotta like walk behind it.
Oh. The X.
Point.
Not a hair perished, and as thou badest me,
I have dispersed them about the aisle.
In troops?
I think.
In troops.
Bravo.
Eric, oh yeah.
Thy charge exactly is performed. But there's more work.
More toil?
More lines.
More lines?
This is what I'm talking about when she goes off script.
More lines!
I don't think I can do this for much longer.
Poor weary spirit. Be of cheer. Thy labors I shall sweeten with a gift. What is
oh, baby.
Thou canst demand?
Liberty, equality, enough already? Enough already!
Oh, come on.
Send me away on my next errand. Please, thine doth merit a reward. I press thee once again. What's thy demand?
Equality or liberty?
Give me liberty or give me death.
Sure.
My liberty.
Thy liberty?
Nay, this most of all I will not grant. That's not her line.
Yeah, right now is when she goes off the script.
What's going on?
But thou hast promised.
Yeah.
But thou assured my freedom. Didn't thou?
I never said how dearly I hold thee. My habit's been to keep my soul well draped. Most loyal spirit, companion, and friend. Is acting in my service not replete with excitement, amusement, and delight?
Of course, mistress. Most truly, it is so.
Mr. Keat, they're way off script.
Stop it!
Then why, I pray you?
It's the greatest thing I've ever witnessed. Excitement isn't happiness?
Excitement's a mere counterfeit of bliss. These storms and these adventures. I prefer to know thou still cared for my plainest self.
I have thee in my grasp. I will not bend. I will not see thee flying forth alone. The envy would be more than
so this is what I'm talking about. Like, it hints at something, but you don't really know. It's like,
yeah.
What's going on? I have no idea.
So come with me.
So come with me. Is that not in thy power?
Spirit, take my hands. Most faithful friend, for but a little longer, I beseech. Continue in thy service to my schemes. And when they are complete, I swear to thee, we shall
finally get
this
married
island.
And leave this.
The corners of the world
place
are
good.
Mere prologue. I'll seek to make thy happiness so great that e'en the name of liberty is forgot. What sayest thou to my most hopeful wish?
I'll do it!
Yeah.
Your duty done for now, so go forth hence with haste.
Can you imagine if that, like, he went to a play and this actually happened, where, like, they went complete,
well done,
completely off script,
and the ending, absolutely,
and it was just like,
yeah, that'd be weird.
I am humbled.
If that was between, like, a guy and girl, I'd be like, they're banging!
Is that real?
Shake it off. Come on. We'll visit Caliban, my slave.
Caliban.
He's a villain, sir. I do not love to look on.
He does make our fire, fetch in our wood. What ho! Slave! Caliban! Come forth,
come
I say!
On! As we could do, as e'er my mother...
Thou poisonous slave, got by the devil himself. Filth as thou art, I have lodged thee in mine own cell. till thou didst seek to violate the honor of my child.
Shit.
He's crying.
Oh, God.
Fetch us in fuel, and be quick. So, slave, hence.
Fuck you.
Ah.
Where should this music be? In the air or the earth?
Oh, thank God.
This play is super intense.
Yeah.
What is it? A spirit? It carries a brave form, but it is a spirit.
No, wench. It eats and sleeps and hath such senses as we have.
I will resist such entertainment.
Put thy sword up, traitor.
Do you love me?
No, I don't.
O Earth, bear witness to this sound. I, beyond all limit of what else in the world, do love, prize, honor you.
His tears run down his beard like winter's drops from eaves of reeds.
Go release them, Ariel. My charms I'll break. Their senses I'll restore, and they shall be themselves.
Well, it's a good thing Rachel now remembered her lines, even though she got canned.
Yeah.
And what strength I have, mine own.
I mean, she's been trying to think. It's not like she's gonna forget him within like
with
a
the
day.
Help of your good hands.
I might.
I probably would, yeah.
Her foot is in the stage.
Nathan didn't even do anything. He was scared.
I think he did what he had to do, though.
Yeah, I don't remember.
He's just upset about it.
Yeah.
Woo! Bring Chloe back out.
Nope, not doing that again.
Wasn't that fun?
You're so dead.
Yeah? How dead?
Hella dead.
Hooray!
One of them parts on stage.
Who's that?
I don't know. I mean, I know, but I'm
isn't not... that the lady that her dad cheated with?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
Oh my God, Keaton's face behind you when you walked on stage. I was shitting myself.
As the city burns.
We don't give a shit about what else.
Shitting himself. That dude owes me.
Watermelon bike.
This is the end.
It seems like it.
There might be one more thing, but I don't remember.
Rests upon your slender shoulders. I've never had an experience like that on stage. Yeah, right? You know, you. Like, seriously. I love nights after a show. Is it always like this? Oh, totally. It's such a high. No more nerves, just the adrenaline.
I don't understand how she ends up with Frank.
First timer, are you proud of yourself?
Yeah. Yeah, definitely.
I am more relieved.
I think I'm just happy.
That's why I wish that this game was longer. That way it would have told you how it happens, like so if Chloe and right now Rachel had like a falling out or something, you know?
Okay. The show was good. I admit it. Yeah. It was magical.
Because I mean, pretty much like after this, like you have no idea how they got together.
Say something silly, hold her hand. Say something sweet.
Hold her hand.
What if I say something sweet and hold her hand?
I have no idea, honestly. I think I held her hand and that was it.
I'm gonna say something sweet. Shut your face!
Well.
Oh, see? Still locked arms.
Yeah, arms, not hands.
So?
What has more meaning? Locking arms or holding hands?
Locking vaginas.
Let's leave. For real.
I want to say this is where you kiss her.
You said you wanted to skip town and never look back. Like I said last night. Let's do it. I know. I've been thinking about that all day. But that was... Don't say it was just a crazy thought. You mean it. I can tell. You want this. Yeah, but...
Jesus. Little aggressive.
Mm-hmm. Let's go now. Didn't we already agree on stage? We can't just... Why not?
Let's leave. No. Fine, you win. Bye.
Fine then, drama queen. Where are we going?
Let's go.
You tell me. What uniquely twisted location does Chloe Price plus Rachel Amber equal?
Your bedroom.
Nova Scotia. The open road, Los Angeles, New York. The open road.
I'm feeling like an indefinitely long road trip. That sounds like
we will live as gypsies.
The greatest idea anyone's ever thought of. You and me driving down the coast, filling up our truck with hilarious souvenirs, and every night we'll find a different beach to walk along and watch the sun go down. And one day, you'll be at a gas station fixing the brakes, and some guy with no shirt on will come up. Yeah, okay. He'll be like, that's so hot that you know about cars. And I'll say, back off. She's with me. You're full of shit.
Damn right.
I love this time of night. Don't you just feel like everything's possible?
Well, let's go. I told you. Let's leave.
Rachel, stop.
Oh, she has to sabotage it.
It's just making me feel like shit that this life you're describing isn't going to happen. For fuck's sake! I've never been more serious in my life. Chloe, what would it take to convince you?
Yeah, this is what it is. Yeah.
Your bracelet, a kiss, a tattoo?
What did I choose?
You chose a kiss. I know you. You're a fucking pervert.
No. Okay.
I'm gonna choose a tattoo. You can't get rid of a tattoo. Well, you can. With a lot of money and pain and burning. But...
Oh, man.
What if I took the bracelet? Wouldn't that fuck things up for Frank?
No, because the second one already happened, so it wouldn't fuck anything up. Really.
I guess.
But, okay, no.
But I'm saying, how would they explain that later?
Okay, so... They really... It doesn't explain how Frank and Rachel start talking.
Even throughout this whole thing, it doesn't?
Yeah, it doesn't.
Oh, that sucks.
Yeah. So... What Before the Storm is basically it's just about
I know it's a prequel, but
yeah, it's just about the beginning relationship of Chloe and Rachel. That's it. It doesn't go any deeper. It doesn't show whenever Rachel gets kidnapped. It doesn't show when Rachel and Frank hook up and everything. It shows nothing of that.
They probably won't, because you know she already died.
Yeah, but I mean, like...
They already showed her dead and buried, and...
Yeah, but I mean, it doesn't show anything of that. It doesn't, like, lead up to that and everything. But on this, I really want to say I put a tattoo. I'm like 60-40 on that.
I want to do a tattoo.
I really want to say I put a tattoo. Cause
I think you did a kiss. I think you're lying. Because you keep saying this is where you kiss her. So you remember you kissing her
but
at some
I
don't, point.
But I really want to say that I did a tattoo as well. I really want to say it.
Why don't you have better memory?
Because it's been so long since I played it. It's been like
so long.
It's been like 6 months since I played it.
That's not even that long.
That is long.
Do you hear that? If you get with Mustachestache, he's going to forget everything he ever said to you. He's going to forget the tattoo that you guys had together in 6 months.
Yeah, do a tattoo. I mean, yeah, just do a tattoo. Just do a tattoo.
I don't know.
Oh my god.
Tattoo.
Give me a promise in ink.
Like a contract?
Nope.
Yeah. Did I do that?
So you did do it. You son of a bitch.
Yeah, I did.
This is temporary. The deal is...
I did.
You get it done for real.
That's right.
Then, I'll believe you. What if I said let's leave tonight?
It's snowing.
Really?
No, it's just the ash.
Oh.
What is this?
It's before the storm. It's the storm. It's the prequel. It's happening!
It's snowing.
Max did this. She's in Washington and she did this.
It's obviously a sign.
It's a sign.
So?
Of the forest burning down. I already said yes.
Let's go sneak some clothes and stuff from my house.
For you or for me?
I gotta say, my clothes look damn good on you.
Cool. Let's do it.
They'll look good on the floor when we're hooking up.
Fuck yes.
And off they ran into the night. They were later captured and murdered. First night on the road. James Amber is your district attorney. She walks really weird sometimes. It bothers me so much.
Yeah, yeah. Like, I wish the animation could have been done a bit better. But as far as, like, the whole game is and how the way it's, like, drawn up.
It's done all right.
Yeah.
I mean, it's clearly done with some, you know, limitations on the budget. But
yeah.
Still, yeah. It's okay.
But I mean,
it's not terrible.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, now I remember. Okay. At least I think I remember. Hopefully I remember.
There's no other way to sneak into your house? Whoops.
No.
You're home.
Ichi got finished taking a poop.
Rose, Rachel's home.
And she's brought her new friend.
And she brought her new friend.
Lover.
Lover.
Our surprise star returns.
Your ex-lover is dead.
Dinner's almost ready. Chloe, was it?
It was.
It is.
It is.
Nailed it. I must have been pretty memorable.
You were. I get the sense that you're used to making an impression.
Rachel, honey, you were resplendent tonight.
Thanks.
Such a big word.
Resplendent.
Oh, yeah.
Shut up. Stop remembering your 20%.
It's up to like 60% now.
I'm sure you both acted up quite the appetite.
Not hungry, just leaving.
I don't remember.
Not hungry.
Yeah, no thanks. I'm more of a burger a la king kind of gal.
She's funny, this one.
Burger a la King.
Chloe, I know we didn't exactly meet each other at our best this morning, but with you and Rachel becoming such fast friends, I insist you join us for dinner. Don't you agree, Rachel?
Yes, of course. Chloe, would you join us for dinner, please?
Please?
Of course.
Great. I just need to wash off. Then I'll be right down.
Don't be long. In meantime, perhaps you can help me with the table, Chloe?
Sure thing, Mrs. Amber.
Okay, I'm gonna go pack. After dinner, we can make our break. You cool down here?
Hurry back.
Just hurry back. I don't know how long I can keep this up.
That's what she
tried
he
doing
said.
It your whole life. And Chloe, we just need to make it through dinner. Try not to say anything that, you know,
that I would normally say.
Exactly.
She seems so sad around her parents.
With the Ambers, what could possibly go wrong?
We don't go out of town and we don't get to do the stuff we want to do. You got.
Okay, I heard you were in the Tempest. Yeah, it was kind of a big deal. I believe it. Everyone says the show was awesome. You get meals, medals for two good deeds a day.
You get meals today.
Mike is okay. Drew would text you in an update in a bit. Oh shit, tell them both I'm pulling for him.
Go beans.
Mm-hmm.
Awards?
Rachel really was an overachiever before she met me.
I nipped that in the bud.
Yep, now I ruined her forever.
Pun intended.
Oh, I think that's an original. Who gives a shit?
Who gives a shit?
Damn. Wonder if this is a family heirloom.
Maybe. Alright, this is all boring. Wait, what is this? Open? I'm gonna break something.
Damn. The Ambers are fancy as shit.
They're so fancy. Shiny. Must play with.
If you want to just get done with this, just talk to, the mom.
Oh. This is actually kind of cool.
Kind of looks like the chick from the ring.
Kinda. Can I go upstairs?
No.
I should stay down here damn until it. Rachel is ready.
Mm-hmm. Why don't we just jump out a window and sneak out? Hey, computer. I think it's weird that you could just walk in front of this dude and use his computer.
Oh, yeah, especially on the other one. Yeah, you can just look at their computer when they're, like, right there.
Yeah.
It's like, don't worry, I'm trying to...
improve? Literal? Illiterate? Literal illiterate? What? Sure, illiterate. I don't know what the hell you're talking about.
Salvador.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah.
Durr. They all
durr,
say durr.
Durr. Durr, 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 durr.
Cool. News article.
Something about this photo doesn't seem right. I should fix it.
What are you gonna graffiti? No, you're in the damn house. Come on.
You just ruined the crossword puzzle.
That's
that the mom was doing.
That's a crossword puzzle. That's not a clipping that they're trying to freaking save.
I guess.
I'm gonna go in this cabinet though.
No skeletons. Lots of shiny dishes though.
Drew, what do you want?
Hey, Price, sorry about what I said earlier. You were only trying to help. No way, I am sorry, Drew. I had no idea what to do. That was so fucked. It's okay, Mikey's alright. I'm alright. Also, he says thanks. Tell him I said hi. Hey. Will do.
Hey, nice to hear from you, guy. I didn't break his knees.
Yeah.
So unlike mean. My friend here who
I
did break
Rose
his knees.
Kill it with my mom.
Oh, shut up. It was perfectly fine. He lived.
Except for his knees.
Yeah. And it was his legs. It wasn't his knees. No, actually, it was his knees.
I'm pretty sure it was his knees.
I don't remember.
Hey there, Mrs. Amber.
Chloe, I'm so glad you're joining us tonight.
Me too.
You borrowed that shirt from Rachel. We call it the Rorschach shirt.
Rorschach.
Yeah.
Kind of a skull, but I'd say more of a bird.
I guess.
So you know what they use those for, right?
Interesting. See if you're crazy.
Yeah, they say like, what's the first thing that comes to mind?
Yeah, that's what I said in the beginning. The inkblot. It's the inkblot test.
So, you putting me to work or what?
Yes. If you could please take 4 plates from the cupboard and set them on the table.
What if I can't?
Excuse me?
You said if I could. Never mind.
Yeah, how does it feel now? How does it feel now, parents? Right, asking Corey, instead of can you, may you? Marriage before.
Could you, may you?
May you?
Grab all the plates and try not to break them. Come on. Oh, I'm not holding them anymore. They're in my butt. Set them. It's a little rough with them.
Yeah. Mom.
Mama.
Mom. Mom. Chloe, Justin Williams' mom just called me. Were you in the play tonight? I would have liked to see that kind of just happen. I know, it was last minute. Well, I'm glad you're doing well. It would be nice to see you tonight. Are you coming home? Please, Chloe, I miss you.
Aw. Mom's gonna make me stay and not elope with my girlfriend. Always messing everything up, Mom. Mm-hmm.
Speak.
Yes, Chloe?
What else do you want?
What next, woman?
What's next?
Plates? Check. Anything else?
Actually, could you be a dear and ask Mr. Amber what he'd like to drink with dinner?
I will be a dear.
She's talking almost screaming like, James, fuck me, right?
As long as I can avoid using
like, you're not in, cheating you're and scumbag, just across the room, you could ask him fine. Yourself.
Why don't you just yell like everyone else's family? What so, the hell do you want to drink? Mr. Amber.
Chloe, what can I do for you?
I'll be upstairs.
Drink?
I'll be upstairs, my mom will call me. She'll be like, Brandon! And I'm like, what? I'll scream. I'll literally scream, what?
She doesn't scream mustache?
No. she'll literally scream. And I'll scream back. And then she'll, won't say anything. And then I'm like, yes! Yes! Ma! And she won't answer me at all. And like, I'm screaming from like the top of the staircase where you can actually hear me. And I have to go downstairs and like, yeah, Ma. She's like, oh, what do you want to eat?
Yeah.
You couldn't have just answered that?
Thank you. We're fond of her as well.
You ever feel like she's so awesome?
She's called me a couple times too.
On your phone?
On the phone to ask what I wanted to eat.
What do you want?
Yeah.
Or she'll be like, food's ready.
My mother never asked me what you wanted to eat. She'd just be like, this is food here.
What's your vice, Mr. Amber?
Scotch on the rocks.
Your wife wants to know what kind of drink you're having.
Ah, let's say sherry.
Sherry? Okay.
1, 2, 3, sherry.
Comical.
I don't understand that at all. It's so awkward.
Because he said, let's say sherry. So she's counted it down for them to say sherry.
We're worried about Rachel.
But yeah, it was really awkward.
What do you suppose is going on?
I think she's a lesbian.
Yeah.
Let's try not to cause too much commotion in her house.
Besides all my bad behavior rubbing off on her, you mean?
Instead of...
Another joke.
I could have attacked you, dude!
It seemed like you and Wells were happy to believe that this morning.
Rachel is her own person. She's
That's weird. It's like the music is going like in one ear, and then it's going in the other ear.
I'd be lying if I said I didn't have concerns about your friendship, but perhaps you're exactly who Rachel needs right now as she navigates the choppy waters of adolescence.
Have puberty.
Puberty.
Thanks.
Get me out of this place, Jesus. We got another talking point?
Yeah.
Hey, Rose, what the hell else do you want?
Yes,
Clay. Oh, yeah. Today. Let's say sherry.
Let's say sherry.
The boss man would like a sherry.
Thank you. The glasses are in the china cabinet. You can place one at his setting.
How am I supposed to get to China? Kidding.
God, they're so white.
They're so tight.
Yeah, they're so bland.
No wonder she hates them.
What's the kind of, like, it's like a literature figure.
It's the triangle shape.
Where it's like you have basic a shapes. Certain person
speaking my language
or something. It's like not comical, it's like just like the generic person. I don't remember what it was.
A jester?
No, it's like whenever you're reading a story, it's like this type of person is in the story. Like, it's just the generic, regular, bland character that has nothing to do with the plot. It's something, but that's what they're kind of like.
I don't know. So, regular person?
I don't remember.
Here's your cup. Oh. Okay.
I just put my butt on it.
Cool. Rub my booty butt cheeks on it. All right, what the hell else do you want, Rose?
That's the one thing I hated, was that you had to keep on going back to her, and it was annoying.
More?
What else?
Pizza. Feel like may I have some more? This.
Only one pants. Last step. As our guest, you may do the honor of lighting the candles. The lighter is in the...
It's cool. I've got my own. Oh. You never know when you'll need to light a candle. Right?
You are a paragon of preparedness.
Thanks. I think.
Now, see, in my opinion, in my home, our guest would not be the one who sets the damn table and who runs around asking everyone what they want. Especially, I don't know, maybe it's because she's so young. Whatever.
I don't know.
Candles? Where the hell did she say they were?
They're just on the table. You just gotta light it.
No. Yeah. Light it. Burn it down!
Burn this fucking world to the ground.
Burn it down.
And fire. What could possibly go wrong?
She's a firebender. Airbender.
Awkward family dinner.
Can we turn the TV on? That's unnerving.
It is.
To have a dinner like that? Like.
So, Chloe? Yeah. Are you and Rachel in any of the same classes?
I like chaos. Actually, most humans like chaos. That's why when you're in school and everyone quiets down for like 3 seconds, everyone's like, what just happened? Why people no make sound no more?
Yeah.
I don't know what she said. I wish.
I wish. Rachel's all honors. I'm still trying to get into remedial... What's it called? Vocabulary.
It's so awkward. Oh my god.
I'm still learning my words.
Dinner's really good, Mom.
Thank you, Rachel.
You're welcome, Mother.
Fire spreads so fast. I've never heard of anything like it.
Me either. It's almost like someone has superpowers.
It's almost surreal. They say a fire like that could only come from a crime of passion.
I swear to God, they made it so no one would ever say the word strange in Life is Strange. They never ever want to say strange.
Now that you said that, like, I realize that that's true.
Even though my option was strange, it was surreal.
Why would anyone do that?
Any number of reasons. With everything going on in the world today, even a town like Arcadia Bay isn't immune to the ills of society.
And it sure isn't immune to Mustache's destroying of the city. How
difficult these last few years have been for you, Chloe. Now that you and Rachel have become friends.
You know what? I wanted Chloe and Max to go ahead and live forever, happily ever after. Cool. And they did. Thanks. So what if it cost the lives of a few hundred people?
A few hundred?
Yes.
Try a couple thousand. Remember
what is most hardly.
Even though that's a small town. Family. There's a couple thousand.
It was 100 at the most.
A gift. It is a responsibility. As such, those still love must be cared for.
It was both of their never families annihilated.
No, it was actually just Chloe's.
That's not true.
Yeah.
No, Max's was
no,
Max's family.
Max's family is in Seattle.
Oh.
Because they moved to Seattle. So what just happened now is that James has been talking about like family and everything, and as you can see,
he's pushing buttons.
Yeah, as you can see, Rachel's like just kind of like really angry because
attack.
Enough of this asshole. Rachel may have to take it, but I don't.
I don't think I did attack. I think I just calmed Rachel. At his
own no. Dinner table. Attack.
I'm not sure I agree, James.
Oh, I thought you of all people would be grateful for family, at least.
Damn. Gratitude, grateful dead ends. Grateful dead end.
Gratitude seems like such a nice luxury. I can't say I've had the privilege to afford it.
That is an excellent point, Chloe. We must always be sensitive to the way our privileges shape our perspectives.
Well said, Mom.
Still, there must be some room for personal responsibility. I'm sure you agree, Chloe.
He's so smug. Responsible like my dad?
My dad was super responsible.
You're like on point with these today.
Then one day, a truck came along and turned him into a super responsible.
Damn.
That's so messed up, Chloe. Damn.
See? This is why it's so important to invite diverse voices. It's absolutely stimulating.
Your mom is broken.
Highly stimulating.
Since you have answers for everything, Chloe, perhaps you'd like to enlighten us with some of your hard-earned wisdom about the world.
Hard-earned wisdom, huh? There's always darkness. Shed some light.
Sure.
Damn.
I believe that we should look closely at everyone, especially the people in power, to see what secrets they're hiding.
Very well articulated, Chloe. I am consistently impressed with how politically aware your generation is.
She's a robot.
She is.
Excellent articulator.
Excuse me, dear? But if this is what passes for politically aware these days, we're in serious trouble.
James, that's unfair.
Mom's
and
in serious trouble.
To Chloe.
No, I don't believe it is. It seems clear that these points Chloe is making are merely veiled attacks on me.
You can't no cover up here.
Oh.
On the level. Unlike
boom.
One guy
there
I
you
know
go.
Whose name rhymes with Schmames. Don't worry, Mr. Amber. I can tell that my progressive attitude is not welcome in this house. I'll see myself out.
James, Chloe is right. You owe her an apology.
That's right.
I owe her no such thing. I believe she's willfully acting belligerently, just as she did this morning. It is how people like her respond to adversity.
People like her? So we're profiling now? This is what 8 months in the DA's office has taught you.
I resent that. My office is committed to fair and equitable treatment.
Yes, I've read the press release.
Excuse me? Are you calling me a hypocrite?
Huh.
Rachel!
I can't sit here and listen to this bullshit anymore.
Rachel!
Stop it, Dad. You're a hypocrite. Okay? I know.
We all know.
You lying, cheating piece of shit.
Damn.
Right.
Excuse me?
We saw
you heard her.
Yesterday. Mm-hmm. At the Overlook.
James.
That's right.
That woman.
James.
With Rachel, your mouth hole.
Honey, whatever you saw or think you saw, I know it's hard, but I need you to trust me.
Trust you? Think we saw?
Think we saw.
Trust you?
Okay.
But I think we trust our eyes more than you.
That's enough. You are not welcome here or around my daughter any longer. I know exactly what kind of person you are from the moment I saw you, and I let my wife's compassion get the better of
me. Oh? What kind of person is
a
that?
A delinquent. A broken girl from a broken home.
Damn.
That's enough, James. I will not have you continue to speak to her like this.
Just like family Thanksgiving all over again.
Hooray! Welcome to Chandler's house. More turkey, Mr. Chandler.
Friends reference for everyone, anyone that didn't get that.
Boom!
Why can't you just tell me the fucking truth? Stop lying! Stop being a politician for one fucking minute! Can't you just be my dad?
I was wondering why their dining table was made of glass.
That wasn't my mistress. That was your mother.
Oh!
Oh my god!
I am born of delinquent blood. I am a mudblood.
Not even.
I mean, Amber is. Because I'm not playing as Amber.
Yeah.
Amber is a mudblood. Oh, he's fine. He broke his arm. Come on. You guys are making it seem like he got shot in the face or something.
There's Papa Dude.
You spilled my beer.
Beach.
That's who he reminds me of. I'm just gonna keep making that connection. To the finish line. It's weird he's never mentioned in the other game. Yeah. I don't think he is.
No. Because most of us are heaving through
corrupted lungs. Setting fire. Oh, he lied. He said it was $1,000. It's $1,050. Collecting names of the lovers that went wrong. The lovers that went wrong. Good job, Victoria. You let everyone down. I feel like she straight up hasn't been home in like a week.
It's only been 2 days.
A week.
It's only been 1 day. It has, because the day before this was whenever they went to the park, and then they went back home. And then they went to the they went in the morning to the school.
Get it, Nathan. You are the lucky one. Talk to your weirdo.
Yeah, like I want to know like what happened to her. Like,
well, she gave him space, so it's okay. You told him to go help.
No.
So then they didn't get together.
Oh, whatever. I don't know why I was being like wasn't even thinking whenever they said that. He said like, that wasn't my mistress, that was your mother. I was thinking, I'm like, wait, how does that work? Like, how is that her?
That's her Rachel's mom, because Rachel was born of the tattoo lady.
No, yeah, and I was thinking, I'm like, how does that work?
What
like,
do you mean,
like,
how that works?
No, like my mind was just like being stupid that day. Like,
you
I was
forgot
like,
how yeah. human anatomy works. I only 22% went along with Rachel's story.
I took the blame. Yeah, so I was one of the 78% that took the blame.
I finally gave in and I let her take the blame. I emptied my pockets at David's request.
I refused to empty my pockets.
You gave Damon the money.
I stayed with Mikey.
Which broke a kid's legs and lost a scholarship. Good job.
Yep.
And asked Rachel to get a tattoo, only 13%. Everyone else was a horn dog and wanted a kiss. And a few people wanted a bracelet.
I'm still 50-50 on that. I need to go back and look and see what I actually put for that. Because I really want to say I asked her to get a tattoo. But then again, I really want to say I asked her for a kiss. But I don't even remember.
I think you went back and did them both.
No, I didn't. I know I didn't. I wish I could have, but this isn't the first Life is Strange, and I can't do that and whatnot, but yeah.
So. I think you can actually still select chapters, so it's still not that difficult to go back.
Yeah, but I mean, I didn't do it. I just played it all the way through.
I don't know. But those are my decisions, and I'm sticking with it, and I did not destroy Arcadia Bay.
You killed Kate.
You killed Kate when you destroyed the bay.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
Yeah, but I didn't know I killed her. And
you did know you killed her.
At least
you made a conscious decision to sacrifice the entire town for one chick.
You know what? At least I saved her whenever she was on the roof. What up? Bam. You're the one that killed her.
I tried. But then you
didn't try.
But you killed her in the end anyways. With my decision, Kate lived.
Okay.
And never died.
No.
She didn't have any of those problems.
No. You know what? First time I
played it. People weren't murdered.
No. First time I played it through, I saved her. And I killed Chloe. So bam. Saved her twice. A second time I went through, I saved her. And I didn't kill Chloe. So the first time that I saved her and I killed Chloe.
You still killed her. Whatever your last decision was, is your last decision. So you decided to blow up the bay.
Not the first time. So it I doesn't saved matter. Her twice.
That doesn't, that's like saying I go back and save her. Oh, look, I saved her. No, I already saved her by saving Arcadia Bay. That's right.
Shut up.
That's right. You're wrong. Anyways.
I saved her at least. And I saved Alyssa.
But then you
and
killed her.
You killed Alyssa.
But then you killed her.
But you killed Alyssa.
I saved the whole town.
You killed
you
Alyssa.
You killed the whole town.
You killed Alyssa.
No, I did not.
Yes, you did.
Remember, at the end, I decide to kill Chloe.
Oh, my God.
Everyone else lives.
I'm not talking about the ending.
I am, because that's what happens at the end.
I don't give a shit about the ending.
No, what is this?
That is...
Oh, these are other smaller decisions.
Yeah.
Has this always been here?
I guess. Okay, so first one. You didn't talk to Elliot about the play. You decided not to go to the play with Elliot.
With Warren, too.
Yeah, you intended to go to the play with Elliot.
Only 15% decided not to go. I thought that would be higher.
I was part of the 15%.
Yeah, you didn't want to show him the light of day.
Nope.
I at least wanted to stay friends with him.
Yeah. You refused to start over. You agreed to start over with David.
Agreed.
I refused over.
Yeah. Most people agreed.
Mm-hmm.
You didn't put the singing man on the dashboard, really?
Yeah.
People decided not to. Okay. Maybe they didn't find it. It's the only thing I could think of. You paid off your debt to Frank, so no one paid off their debt to Frank.
Well, if you think about it, in the first episode, when you give him the 200 cash...
I had to steal it.
Yeah. I mean, you already paid him off. So the fact that this is part of it, this doesn't make any sense. That should have been part of the first one.
Doesn't really. Unless it's talking about handing over the money?
No.
It's talking about
the 175, because... Whenever in the first episode, when you go to Frank, you're like, hey, do you have some weed or are you holding? And he was like, you still owe me 175. Remember? He was like, yeah, I have this and everything. He's like, what are you doing? Yeah. So, I mean, that choice.
That's weird that it's here.
Yeah. It should be in the second one. Because, I mean, you could have saved the money and took in it from the first episode to the second episode and then paid him. But, I mean, if you already have the money right there, then it should have been in the first one.
Yeah. That's weird.
Yeah.
So you didn't tell Steph that Rachel was single.
Yeah, I did that. You told Steph that Rachel was single.
No one's going to do that. You didn't return Drew's money to him.
I didn't.
No, you did.
No, I didn't return it to him. That's saying you gave the money back to Drew.
Oh.
Yeah, I didn't do that.
So, wait.
I gave the money to Damon. Or I gave it the money to Frank. That's who I gave the money to. So Drew has no money at all.
Okay. I don't know. It's weird because he gets his money either way. So it's weird that he gets his legs broken in your scenario. You know?
Well, the only reason why he got his legs broken in my scenario was because he told me to stay in the room with Mikey to keep Mikey safe.
Yeah.
And that's what I did. And Damon was kept on like beating him, like trying to figure out where his money was and everything. And so that's why it was just basically like, that's why he got his legs broken. Because I mean, you cross a drug dealer, like, you're going to get something broken. Either that or you're going to die. 9 out of 10 times, you're going to die.
Or you just get high, you know.
Yeah.
Told Samantha to avoid Nathan was the lowest at 3%. You told me to tell her to avoid him. You terrible.
I told
human.
You to help him.
You told you no. You said for her to.
No,
leave him.
I told you to help him.
You said to leave him.
To help him.
Leave him.
I told you to help him. I will bet you $10 that I told you to help him.
I will not take that bet because you're probably right.
You're damn right. I'm right.
So you're the 33%.
Yeah.
Is that what you did or do you not remember?
No, actually, like, I didn't even realize. So when during that whole spot, whenever it was just I just got fed up with it, like, glitching on me. Like, the voices weren't moving. I couldn't hear any audio and it was freezing up on me. I just got fed up with it that I, like, whenever I resetted it, I just went straight to the girl's dorm or the girl's thing.
Tent.
And yeah. I just got it over with and everything. So, like, when the third episode, I may be able to see more of, like, Samantha and Nathan's kind of story. Because, like, I feel like whenever I played it through the first time, I didn't see that story as much as I am seeing it right now. Like, I'm actually seeing it right now, like, through, like, a new lens for, the first time.
Yeah.
And everything. Where it wasn't as more, it wasn't as, like, prominent in... whenever I played it through the first time.
So you discouraged Victoria from acting in the play. Shut her down. Okay, not many encouraged Victoria before the play, which no one really should have.
Yeah, so whenever I played Victoria? Victoria had the choice to kind of not poison, but just make Rachel sick before the play. And I told her... she basically had two teas and put, like, medicine in one of them. And I told Rachel to drink the one that wasn't spiked and to give the other one to Rachel and everything. And then Rachel, like, moved out and whatnot, and she was really pissed.
You told Rachel you'd like to go on a road trip. That seems like a dumb one. That's why it's so, you know, not 50-50, but... yeah. You know, everyone's spread out evenly.
Yeah. I think I told her to go to Los Angeles.
Road trip.
I want to say I did that, yeah.
And I attacked James at dinner, yeah.
Rachel attacked James at dinner is what I chose. 71%.
So I'm kind of happy I did that, so.
Mm-hmm.
Vroom! Tune in next time when we find out if the truck works.
Used to be an adventurer like that. Then I took an arrow. I used to be an adventurer like you. Then I took an arrow in the knee.